the St. Louis Cardinals have a way about them. It's called the Cardinal Way. You see this term used in reference to their player development, draft strategy, and even their approach in free agency. But there's another term used in a similar vein to this. Devil magic. This is more of a reference to how the Cardinals are in contention every year and come up with big postseason hits. But where the Cardinal Way and Devil Magic overlap is with how the Cardinals consistently turn overlooked prospects into big league players. And that's what we're going to look at today. My name is Bobby, and welcome back to Stat Stories. This video was suggested by Mark Reed, and shoutouts to David Cannon, Cam Streeter, Boughton Big Moose, and Tabin Park, who wanted videos on the Cardinals. And as a reminder, Outta Here Baseball is a partner of Unhinged Media and Grunt Talks MLB. So when I started research for this video, I was fortunate to find that Kyle Glazer of Baseball America had written an article talking about the Cardinals' devil magic and some recent players who were overlooked as prospects. The players he mentioned specifically were Daniel Descalso, Paul DeJong, Skip Schumacher, Tommy Edman, Greg Garcia, Alan Craig, Matt Carpenter, Luke Voit, and Matt Adams. All nine of these players, who if you didn't notice are primary infielders or utility players, were drafted out of college, and none were drafted in the first two rounds. I've listed them from earliest round to latest, so our range goes from round 3 all the way to round 23. On top of this, none of these players were ever top 100 prospects in baseball, and only Alan Craig was a top 5 prospect in the Cardinals system. Now, why were these players not valued very highly? In general, these guys weren't very toolsy, and by that, I mean they didn't possess the raw skills that would blow you away. They also didn't have the physical profile typical of their preferred position, or they didn't even have a set defensive position. Again, this is just in general, so each of these statements may not apply to each player. One quote that I found interesting from the article, which I linked in the description, is from Cardinals GM Mike Girsch. Referring to the Cardinals' drafting philosophy over the past 10 to 15 years, we were probably using college stats in a way that might have been aggressive at the time. So the Cardinals were placing more emphasis on college stats than other teams, especially when the players we mentioned were drafted. Let's build off of that and look at the college stats for some of those players. Specifically, we'll be looking at 3-time All-Star Matt Carpenter out of Texas Christian, 1-time All-Star Alan Craig out of Cal Berkeley, 2019 All-Star Paul DeJong out of Illinois State, 2019 rookie Tommy Edman out of Stanford, and 2019 World Series winner Matt Adams from Slippery Rock University, which is a Division II school in Pennsylvania. I'm also going to look at 2011 postseason hero David Freese, who was initially drafted by the Padres out of South Alabama. As you may know, college stats are tricky to quantify given the differences in play between conferences and differing coaching philosophies. So I'm mainly going to be comparing these players to their teammates and seeing where they stood out the most. So beginning with Matt Carpenter, it's worth mentioning that he underwent Tommy John surgery in his junior year, meaning he was granted a medical redshirt and played at TCU until he was 23. The 6'3 second baseman would develop some home run power after his return from injury, hitting 11 home runs in both his junior and senior seasons, but he was more of a doubles hitter, which is also true of his major league career. The thing that stands out the most about Carpenter's collegiate career is a very high walk total with low strikeouts. 31 walks and 21 strikeouts as a junior is pretty good, but 51 walks to 24 strikeouts as a senior is phenomenal. In terms of percentages, his walk rate as a senior was the best on the team, and his strikeout rate was the lowest. Next is Alan Craig, who played all over the infield and even a bit in the outfield while in school. He was the team's offensive leader as a senior and posted a very good slash line, with his batting average standing out in particular. He also led the team in doubles and homers, and while he didn't draw walks at the rate Carpenter did, he had the lowest strikeout rate on the team among the regular starters. Paul DeJong is known now as a top-notch defensive shortstop, but at Illinois State, he filled in all over the infield, including at catcher. He's different from our previous two players in that his walk and strikeout rates weren't very notable, but what he had going for him was power. 9 home runs as a sophomore, the next closest on his team had 4. 14 home runs as a junior, his closest teammate had 6. Add in a solid hitting approach beyond the home runs, and you can see why the Cardinals took him in the 4th round. Next, we have the 5'10" Tommy Edman, who was an all-conference shortstop for Stanford in his junior year. While he only hit 4 home runs across his 3 collegiate seasons, he provided top-notch speed and got on base enough to make that speed count. Like Carpenter and Craig, Edmund didn't strike out, posting the lowest strikeout rate on his team in his junior season. And for context, Stanford's strikeout rate as a team was a little over 14%. We move now to Matt Adams. His stats at Division II Slippery Rock were just absurd. Video game numbers is a good way to describe his slash line in his junior year. He had the best batting average in the nation for Division II players, and was near the top in on-base percentage and slugging percentage. As a result, he was named 2009 Division II Player of the Year by the National Collegiate Baseball Writers Association. And continuing with the theme we've seen with 3 of our previous players, Adams had a very low strikeout rate. Lastly is David Fries, a 9th-round pick of the Padres in 2006, who, like Matt Carpenter, was 23 years old when drafted. Fries was a standout third baseman for South Alabama, being named Sun Belt Conference Player of the Year in his senior season. He led the team in just about every category, and was among the leaders for all of Division I baseball in the slash line categories. And once more, he had the lowest strikeout percentage on his team, and had the second best walk percentage. So after going through all these players, we established that they struck out at a very low rate and drew an above average number of walks, with the exception being Paul DeJong. This disciplined approach to hitting is taken into consideration when grading a player's hitting ability, but it is also part of baseball's 6th tool, a player's mentality. Work ethic, being a team player, having that X factor that makes you say, yeah, that's a ball player right there. These are the qualities you can't measure well, or even measure at all. It takes a lot of time to get a grasp of a player's mental game, and since college players play more games than high schoolers, you get to see them in lots of different situations, which would explain why all the players we looked at were college draftees. These intangibles play a big part in any organization, and maybe the Cardinals just have the secret to tapping into those mental traits and getting the most out of their players. And whether you chalk that up to the Cardinal Way or to Devil's Magic, you can't deny that it's been successful. Before you go, check out the World of Baseball podcast, link in the description. I was featured as a guest recently talking about prospects, and Benzie was fun to work with, so feel free to show him your support. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this look at the Cardinals and their knack for developing unheralded prospects. Leave a like and share the video, and remember to subscribe to help the channel grow and reach more people. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.